Hey ho, Jim Barron here with Blue Mesa Thrill of the Grill. Going crazy here. We're in Santa Barbara having fun with the summer. Talking about grilling, marination, glazes, and different relishes. We did pico de gallo and roasted corn and black bean relish. And now we're going to talk about the marinades. We're going to start off with our chicken marinade, which is a soy chipotle marinade with pineapple juice. So the first thing we do is start off, we take water and we heat it, and I added a cup of sugar and about a third of a cup of salt. That's really going to be a brine. A brine is where you use a lot of salt at a very low temperature, 40 degrees, and the salt gets the marinade to really penetrate the product, in this case chicken. So I heated up water and got the salt and the sugar to dissolve. Then I'm using chipotle chiles. A chipotle is a jalapeno pepper that's been pickled in an adobo sauce. So it's primarily available as a canned product in the supermarket. And it looks like this. You can see the chili, and it's in an adobo sauce. So, and it's very spicy and has a smoky flavor. It's got a wonderful quality, but it is hot. So I'm going to add a quarter cup of my chipotles. I'm also going to add a quarter cup of red wine vinegar. I'm going to add a cup of pineapple juice. These are 6 ounce cans, so I'm going to dump one in and a little bit more. Some fresh garlic. I'm just going to do this by eye. And then a half a cup of soy sauce. Be good if I had it open first, but this is a quarter cup measure, so there goes one, and there goes two. And then I'm gonna mix this all up in my blender. There you have it. I've got ice, and I'm going to add ice to it because you want it to be cold. You don't want it to be warm, and I want to bring the temperature down. So I'm going to add a little bit of ice, make sure it stays cold. Then you might, reduce your water content a little. And then I'm going to add my chicken. And I use a bag. I love marinating in a bag because, it really gets the marinade to go around. And I've cut the chicken into small pieces. Make sure if you're touching the chicken, which I'm going to do, that you really wash your hands very well before you touch anything else. So I'm going to add my chicken. You might want to wear gloves when you're doing it and then change your gloves. But anyway, from a food safety standpoint, chicken is something that you got to be careful about. And then I'm going to add my marinade, hopefully not spill it all over the kitchen. I did good. Surprised myself. And there you have it. And I've cut the chicken in small pieces so that there's more surface area to marinate. And this is really more marinade than I really needed in this case. I could have used this for about four times as much chicken, but it's certainly not going to hurt anything. And then I'm going to put this in the refrigerator and keep it cold. I like to marinate chicken at least 6 hours. You can marinate it up to 12. When you take it out of the brine, dry off the chicken, make sure there's no surface salt on it, and then I'm going to put it on skewers and grill it. That's it.